Hello, ladies and gentlemen, and welcome to this Let's Play of the Ur-Quan Masters. Now, as you can see at the bottom right there, I am running the Ur-Quan Masters fan remake, which is not the original Star Control 2. This has a lot of stuff that Star Control didn't have. For instance, we can go into the setup menu here and just show you, like, we have resolution options, we have scalers, we have the ability to run 3DO or PC UI and cutscenes, and we also have custom music, we have the, what are they called, the precursors. Ur-Quan Masters remixes of all the music in the game. This is why you're listening to this absolutely fantastic, mega awesome, hyper amazing menu music in the background. What this gives us is basically the original game, the original voice acting, the 3DO version cutscenes, and a choice between PC and 3DO UI. We also get high quality music made by the precursors, and also HD, or at least high definition, as in higher resolution textures. So the original game ran at 320 by 240, I think. This is scaled up to 640 by 480. Or not scaled up, these textures are remade to 1280x960. So it's still small resolution by today's standards, and as you can see, it's also 4x3. But it's essentially as good as it gets with an old game like this. So, enough talk, let's get going. So we start the game by selecting and typing in our name. And it might be a little weird that the name window that you type your name in is all the frick over there, but you will see why in a minute. And since my name is Mana, I will just... Do I call myself Mana? Now, let's just go with Mana. And my ship. What is the name of our flagship? It's not the Vindicator, even though that's a nice name. We'll go with... Valiant. That's what we'll do. And now you can see why we had it up there. Because that's where we'll see that the entire game. We'll start by saving the game. Save game. And I am going to go down here and save it here and call it LP01. Okay, now that we've saved, we are here in the Sol solar system. You can see all the planets, including Pluto. Even though Pluto isn't actually a planet anymore, but by the time this game was made, it was a planet. And as you can also see, Earth, the third rock from the sun, has a bit of an odd color on it. So let's go to navigate and fly down there. Oh my god, I'm gonna miss the planet. Ah! Crap. This thing does not turn on a dime, let me tell you. Okay, we're not going to Mercury, can we please? Ah! There we go. Alright. Ha! Ah, hi! What the balls?
Attention, interloper. Heed this recorded message. This drone vessel speaks with the voice and authority of Ur-Quan. You are trespassing within Ur-Quan space. This world, Earth, may not be approached for any reason. Nor will hostilities against our orbital platform be tolerated. In addition, your ship does not respond to standard hierarchy identification transmissions and is therefore deemed to be independent. This is not permissible. Only subservience shall be tolerated. this drone now leaves to inform the Ur-Quan of your transgressions. You are commanded to remain here and await the arrival of the Ur-Quan. Disobedience will be punished.
Okay. Can we talk about this? Nope. Apparently not. Fine. Alright. Let's stay away from that station, shall we? We will have a look at Earth. It is awfully red. Let's scan it. We can't scan it. So apparently the red atmosphere, aka slave shield, is preventing us from scanning it. Well then. Let's head to the station and have a talk to them then. Hello?
Attention, unidentified space vessel. I am Starbase Commander Hayes of the slave planet Earth.
Situation critical. Energy cores exhausted. Scanners and deep radar are non-functional.
We cannot identify your vessel. Are you the scheduled hierarchy resupply ship? Repeat. Are you the resupply vessel?
Do we? No. Okay.
What?
Never mind. Look, we won't last much longer. Here's our situation. According to our oath of fealty to the Ur-Quan, we must maintain the starbase, but we have no space vessels of our own, and the shield prevents us from contacting Earth, so we're totally dependent on the Ur-Quan supply vessels for everything we need up here. We know there's a hierarchy base on Earth, but we can't contact them. The Ur-Quan was supposed to resupply the base at regular 5-year intervals, but we haven't received anything in almost 8 years. What we don't recycle, we can usually synthesize. But to do so, we need replacement radioactives for our generator energy cores. If you could bring us some radioactive elements, we can fabricate the cores ourselves. Are you willing to help us?
Oh yeah, you're human, so why not? Where can we find them?
The fastest way to get radioactives in this system would be to land on Mercury and scour the surface for deposits of radioactive elements. But be careful. Mercury's a pretty inhospitable place. Watch out for Earthquake and those high temperature areas.
Okay.
Anyway, make sure to visit us the next time I talk with our masters. I'm sure they will reward you.
Okay. Mercury, you say? Mercury sounds pretty dangerous, to be honest. Where else could you find radioactives in the Earth's solar system?
No,
I didn't mean to talk to you. I'm sorry. Can we? Yes, we leave. I am so sorry. Your starbase moved. Let's have a look at Mars? Maybe we can find some radioactives on Mars. We never know. Mars doesn't seem quite as inhospitable as Mercury. Wah! No! Ah, crap. This thing has a terrible turning. Yeah! Nyeh. Okay. Is it? No, 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 not Earth. Not Earth. Ah, come on. Mars. No! God, this thing is hard to fly. Okay, no! Let's take this slow. There we go. Hello, Mars. Oh my God. Scan. No, it's Venus. Of course it is! Mars is on the outside. Wow, I can't believe I failed on that. Alright. So what are these things? Oh god. How did I even... Yeah, why did I scan Venus? Venus has a terrible weather. It's class 8. We should probably leave. And go for actual Mars. Good lord, Mars is the fourth planet. What? Where the hell did I get... Never mind. It's on the other side, okay. Mercury, Venus, Earth, Mars. How the hell did I fail on that? Alright, let's take this slow. Like... So? There we go. Hello, actual Mars. Okay, scan. This one looks safe. Well, there are minerals. No energy signatures and no biologicals. Now the question is, of course, manifest. Radioactives are orange. There are no radioactives here, so we'll have to leave. On the other hand, we might as well just pick them up, you know. So, dispatch and pick up whatever we can find. Whee! Hello. Take some base metals. Aluminium. Bismuth. Whee! Dispatch and pick the last two up. Wow, that wasn't a lot. They're worth three each. That's nice. Okay, now let's go find some radioactives. No! Exit menu, navigate. Fine, let's go to Mercury then. Don't like the idea of going to Mercury though. It seems rather unsafe. Oh, great. I forgot. Yeah. Haha. Hello, hot planet. It's actually not too bad. Oh, there are radioactives here. We'll go straight for the radioactives here. Just dive down and get them and be ready to escape! In case it gets very, very hot. Dude, there was a lot of stuff here. Maybe we should pick the rest of it up, too. I'm gonna get as much as I can. Just avoid the flaming things. Wow, there's a lot of stuff here. Land here. Ah! Please, flamey worms, leave me alone. Ow! Ooh. Oh! Welp. Well, we have what we needed, so let's head to this... God damn it, I blew up my vessel. Oh, well. I am so slow. I get hit by fire and... What's it called? An earthquake at the same time. Or a mercury quake, I suppose. Right. To the starbase we go. And have a little sprache with you.
Did you find any radioactive elements for our power core?
Yes, we did. We are ready to transfer.
I'm sorry, Captain, your message was garbled. Our receivers have very little power.
Alright, fine.
Initiating transfer of radioactive, Captain. Now, as soon as our engineers can refit the energy cores, power ratings are climbing, life support is coming back into the green. Deep radar systems and sensors are now online, and I can scan your vessel. What the hell kind of ship is that? Just who are you, Captain?
I am Captain Mana of the Starship Valiant.
Star Control Science Mission, huh? Captain, I served as a Star Control officer during the war aboard several cruisers in the Corward Front. And if there'd been any scientific mission to Vela, I would have heard about it.
Oh, really?
You know, come to think of it, there were some rumors that Corridor 9, the Special Operations Division of Star Control, was directing some hush-hush operation near Anderson Space. The Vela Star System. Yes, that would be the right direction. So, Captain, if you say it's true, how do you explain that huge alien starship you're flying? And why are you here? What do you want from us?
We have returned to Earth to give you the technological secrets of the precursors and to help you fight the hierarchy.
Fight the Ur-Quan. Win back our freedom. I remember having such thoughts myself once, long time ago. That was in the first years after the defeat, when it was still terrifying to look up and see the bloody glow of the pulsating slave shield overhead. So day and night we gazed up at the impenetrable wall as though the sheer power of our hatred would pull it down. But over the years I spent so much of my time struggling down on the surface, under the shield, and then later up here trying to keep the station alive, that I'd forgotten what it means to be free, to hate our Ur-Quan masters. And now here you are, in an alien ship of unknown power, offering me your assistance to fight against the hierarchy again after all these years. Captain, your offer is intriguing. It's tempting to think that with your advanced precursor technology, you can somehow crack the Earth's slave shield and reassemble the Alliance to attack the hierarchy. And this time, win the damn war. Consider the consequences if you should fail. The Ur-Quan won't just punish us here on the station. They'll exact a gruesome retribution on the surface below as well. Before I commit this station to helping you attack the Ur-Quan and accepting the risk of annihilation if we are defeated, I have to make sure that you and your ship have what it takes to oppose the hierarchy. I'll make you a deal. If you can eliminate the alien base on the moon and get rid of that threat at least, I will seriously consider your offer.
Okay. Due to circumstances beyond our control, our only landing vehicle was destroyed. Can you replace it?
Manufacturing a new lander for you will use most of what little resources we have left, but I suppose we have no choice. We will transport the new lander vehicle immediately.
Ahem. Ahem. Ahem.
After the Ur-Quan erected the slave shield around the Earth and established this space station, they decided to leave a contingent of combat ships close to the Earth to keep watch on our planet and confirm that they were obeying the Ur-Quan slave laws. I'm certain they're still out there on the surface of the moon because we can pick up a constant stream of alien broadcasts.
Okay.
Be careful, Captain. There are probably a dozen Spathia looters and Ill-Wrath Avengers down there on the lunar surface. I don't know why they haven't come after you yet, but when they do, you'd better have your weapons armed and your thrusters burning hot.
Oh, great. Combat. That sounds great. All right. I think that's enough for the first episode. In the next episode, the moon! Toodles!